we in Islam are made to believe through the lips of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ, was one of the mightiest messengers of God. We believe in his miraculous birth, that without any male intervention he was born. We believe in his many miracles, including those of giving life to the dead by God's permission and of healing those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. We believe. But we are in conflict with regards to his birthday. I was questioned whether we commemorate Christmas. I said, look, we enjoy Christmas holidays. Christmas holidays we enjoy, but we don't commemorate Christmas. If we only knew the date of his birth, we would also celebrate his birthday. Like it's a Miladul Nabi. We'll have Miladul Masih. We'll have the birthday of Jesus. But when was he born? They tell us 25th of December. Christmas Day, 25th of December. But he was not born on the 25th of December. Today the Christians have come to realize, the learned men of Christendom, that he was not born on the 25th of December. This 25th of December is the day, is the date of the birth of the pagan sun gods. Not the Son of God. Son of God in inverted commas. Not the Son of God. But the sun god. What it means? You see, you people here, this is the northern hemisphere. I come from the south. This is the northern hemisphere. And as winter approaches, December, it gets colder and colder here for you people. And as December 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, the primitive man, he could sense day by day, they can see the sun in the distance. Far away, it's going east to west, further and further away, and it's getting colder and colder. So they personify that the devil is eating up the sun. So they start beating drums and start offering prayers that the sun may not be swallowed up, because if it gets swallowed up, it'll be finished for good. 24th of December, the equinox, and now you see the 25th. Those primitive people in the northern hemisphere, they could sense the variation in temperature day by day. 25th, they can see the sun coming back into its own. In other words, the sun has now come out supreme. It has not been, the devil didn't follow up the sun. It's coming back. So that is the date of the birth of the sun god. Sun god, the sun has come back into its own. Those, they celebrated Christmas. Birth of, not Jesus Christ, the birth of the sun god, Baal, Horus, Apollo, Astarte, all these were the sun gods worshipped in the Mediterranean region, and their birthday was the 25th of December. So when the people became Christianized under Constantine, they accepted that birthday of the sun as the birth of the Son of God, in inverted commas. So it is not the birthday of Jesus. The Quran tells us very, very clearly that when Jesus was born, his mother Mary was told, he says, shake the palm leaf, the leaf of the palm leaf, date palm, and it will let fall fresh ripe dates. Means the dates were ripe, ready. You just shake it and the thing will fall. And you can eat and refresh yourself with the rivulet, with the small river running by, refresh yourself. After the birth of the child, she is told that. So it was midsummer. If the Quran says that the dates were ripe, it means midsummer, not midwinter. Palestine is in the northern hemisphere. Your winter and their winter is the same. So you don't have winter in midsummer. Dates in midsummer. So it was midsummer. Then the Bible also says that when Jesus was born, the shepherds were out in the field. Now the shepherd is a fool. If he with his sheep stays out in the open in Palestine, in midwinter, he will freeze to death, and his sheep will freeze to death.